puck is dropped. Kelly at the poker. Poker gets left and score. Anstrong waits, takes the set, goes! The Faraway Police has won the Stanley Cup.
May 2nd, 1967. The city of Toronto won its 13th Stanley Cup. And in the years since that victory, the team has seen more lows than highs, more disappointment than joy. Yet the fans remain loyal. The fans remain strong. The fans continue to believe.
I've been a Leaf fan since 1974. I was 5 years old when I started watching the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Being a fan of your team is something that you're born into.
A lot of loyalties are passed down from generation to generation. So maybe your dad cheered for the Leafs, or your uncle, or someone in the family passed that love to you.
I remember my old man taking me to watch games, or just being on the TV watching games.
You know, in my house, my dad cheers for the Leafs. I followed him.
For some reason, it is a religion here. It's not a sport, it's a way of life.
I still remember vividly the first game I went to, like Maple Leaf Gardens, and it was the Leafs against the Red Wings. And
when you love a team that much, and when you love them, like it's in my blood, you know? I bleed Maple Leafs, I breathe Maple Leafs, and I live for the Maple Leafs, right? And that's just the way I am.
There's Leaf fans in San Jose, there's Leaf fans in Atlanta, there's Leaf fans in Buffalo. It doesn't matter where Toronto goes, somebody's wearing this jersey.
Even the way you walk out into your seats, you're like right on ice level, and then you go up and just seeing the players skate around the first time.
Don't really think we have a choice, you know, we're Torontonians, that's our team.
The Toronto Maple Leafs are having another dismal season, but as usual, it hasn't affected the legendary loyalty of their fans.
Sometimes, like, oh God, I'm like the stupidest fan in the world, right? Like, no matter what they do wrong, I'm still supporting them.
From the outside looking in, I'd be like, why do these guys vote for the fans? Why did they vote for the Leafs? You know, it would bother me too. But being on the inside, I'm like, why would we vote for anybody else?
You know, it's amazing to me how poor the team has gotten over the last couple of years, and people just keep going.
Maybe I'm a little masochistic, or maybe I just have some false hope. I don't know, but it's just the excitement that maybe one day they will reach the Stanley Cup. Who knows?
You'd be stupid to give things up on a short, bad spell like they are right now, because when things turn around, you'd be left out in the cold.
When you finally win, you don't want to be on some other team, supporting some other team by then, and you're gonna miss out.
I think that there's sort of some sort of a unity there in being a Leafs fan, and that you are hated by everyone else, and that when they finally win, if they win, that there'll be they'll sort of rejoice in that.
It's easy to support a winner. It's hard to support a team that has seen more lows than highs.
It's kind of like insanity. It just seems that in Toronto, when somebody wants to go somewhere, they just want to go to the ACC, or when it was Maple Leaf Gardens. You know, they love hockey, and they're dedicated to the game. They just love it.
It's kind of stupid, but it, just being stubborn and like just sticking with it forever, yeah.
Everyone you talk to talks about the glory days, so are all older guys and generation. I would like to see that in my life.
One advantage to being my age is that at least I can claim to have seen them win four times, and I was 15 in 67.
It will come soon, you know, hopefully during my lifetime I'll be able to see it.
So will the second coming of Christ, I think.
Well, you get into friendly arguments, usually friendly, not always, with people from time to time.
I was walking down the street, some guy pulls up in a car in front of me, rolls down his window, goes, Leafs, and then drives off.
Whatever, your envy is appreciated. What can I say? Come be a Leaf fan, we'll take you out.
Being a Montreal fan, I'm always a Montreal fan, but I've learned to hate the Leafs less as I've gotten older.
When Leaf fans go into Vancouver, Calgary, Edmonton, for example, Montreal, and make a lot of noise, I think that irks the local fans.
The Leafs are an easy target. I get more bad Leaf jokes emailed to me by other, you know, people I know than anything else.
Leaf Nation sucks, and why would you guys vote for the Leafs? And you guys are a laugh, and the loafers and the maple laughs.
What do Leafs and the Titanic have in common? They both look good until they hit the ice.
You're a joke, the team's a joke, and if you're a Leaf fan, you're a joke. And
Toronto is perceived probably everywhere but Toronto as being maybe a little bit arrogant and not that likable.
If it's a Montreal fan, they just compare the Stanley Cups and whatever. Like, we haven't heard that before.
So why are they jealous of us? Because no matter what, no matter how down low we go, even if we lose every game of the season, Leaf Nation is still behind the blue and white, and they just can't get it.
I'm just sick and tired of listening to all the criticism that we get for the real Leaf fans, you know, the guys that care about the team.
They've really exploited, as they call it, the brand. For about the last 15 years. Anything that they can grab, they'll stick a Maple Leaf on it and expect it to sell based on the loyalty of the fans to the Maple Leafs. It's disgusting, really.
If you go to the games, it's really corporatized. There's always commercials on. There's never a lot of cheering except in the playoffs.
You go to the Leaf game and I want to cheer, and I've been told to stop. I'm being too loud and stuff, or people in front of you are on their Blackberries talking, and it's just ridiculous.
I think there are a lot of fans that are shut out entirely. You know, you can be a Leafs fan and never ever go to a game in person just because of how expensive it is, which is, it's just too bad.
Can't get anything but like the second to last row in the corners, and it's so quiet in there. You can hear people's conversations like from across the building. You can hear someone sneeze, right? And there's just not that atmosphere anymore.
And so fathers and sons and mothers and sons and daughters and, you know, they're all missing that experience, which is huge in our culture.
When you walked into Maple Leaf Gardens from Carlton Street, the main entrance, as soon as you came through those doors, you could smell the ice. It smelled like a hockey rink. It smelled like hockey rinks everywhere across Canada, the smallest rink to the largest. So you knew you were in for a hockey experience. When you walk into this place, you smell money. You don't smell the ice, you smell money. That's the biggest difference. It's not a rink. It's a money-making venue, machine.
Everything changed when they went into the ACC, became corporate. It sucks to see that. I mean, the Leafs need push sometimes, and at the start of a period, there's hardly anybody in the front seats.
I feel sorry for the fans in Toronto that they have to pay so much to come to games. And, you know, I think a lot of the fans that you see can only afford tickets up in the far reaches of the arena. They can only afford to go to one or two games every couple of years, and it's too bad.
It does upset me a little bit when I see those empty seats, yeah. I would rather, it'd be nice if there was just the average family that was in those seats, but that's not the case.
It's hard to see that as a fan sitting out here. Is like, I would be the guy that's watching the game from, you know, start of the puck drop to the last whistle.
I think Toronto really deserves to have better.
In the old days, it was a hockey team. Now it's a brand, and perhaps secondarily, a hockey team.
Who do we blame? The teachers' pension fund, MLSE, you know, like, it's all a faceless corporation to us that are in charge of our beloved team.
MLSE is making all this money, sold out all the time, because no matter what kind of product they put out there, like, the fans will still come.
Like, one of the big things other fans like to say is, well, if you guys stop going, the team will get good again, because they'll have to get good. They'll have to improve the on-ice performance. But the reality is, there's just so many Leaf fans, and only not even 20,000 tickets.
No one's not going to go to the games, so can't say stop going to the games, because that's not going to happen, right?
For the first time since I've been covering this team, and I've been doing it for 20 years off and on, I've seen a real note of bitterness there and anger.
Canadians are often described as hockey mad, but lately some are just mad. Fans of the failing Toronto Maple Leafs have begun showing their displeasure.
Some fan has decided to throw something on the ice.
The waffles are on the ice again.
If they're awful, we waffle.
Another ugly Maple Leafs loss and another chance for frustrated Leafs Nation to unleash their wrath on the player.
It's not fun getting booed in your own building.
The team's failure on the ice has led to some success off it in the form of a viral video.
I'm tired of losing seasons, and I do think we deserve better.
We get the product on the ice. It's hockey. I mean, you can watch hockey anywhere if you want to watch good hockey, but our hockey's not good hockey.
When it gets really bad, you know, 5-0 games, it's just flick off the TV and just go to my room or whatever and cry, but, you know.
Last year, I was really upset. I just gave up the last 10 games. I really, you know, didn't really want to watch it that much.
The Leaf experience has changed from them being our heroes, something that we live, breathe, and eat, into kind of something in the background.
You know, all we're thinking right now is we don't make the playoffs. We sit at home, we watch other teams. I mean, those are bad memories, watching another team play in the playoffs. I mean, I don't want to sit there and cheer for some other team, you know.
So I think I will see them win another cup, because otherwise I'd be depressed.
Basically, I want them to win. That's it. You're a sports team. Win.
Frustrated, tired, disappointed. Three words that summarize what it's like to be a Leafs fan. Yet if you talk to anyone who cheers for the blue and white, they will all tell you the exact same thing.
I'll be a Leaf fan forever, man. I have children of my own. I'm going to make them Leaf fans.
I'll always be a Leaf fan. My kids will be raised as a Leaf fan, and if they choose otherwise, then they can get the hell out.
I'm really glad that if I had to pick one team that's a loser at this point, then I'm part of Leaf Nation.
Toronto fans can always hope and wish for something better.
I don't think Montreal will ever win another Stanley Cup.
I don't think so. They're that far away. In fact,
I think they're just really wimpy.
I think Leaf fans are best to be avoided.